első filmjért, a Whiplashért két Oscar jelölést kapott. A másodikért, a kaliforniai álomért pedig már két Oscart vihetett haza. Nemrégiben Párizsban rendezett tévéfilmet, most pedig Emma Stone-nal és Brad Pitt-tel forgatna, ha vége lenne végre a koronavírusnak.
How are you doing?
I'm doing fine. How are you doing?
I'm good. I'm good. Just cooped up at home.
Doesn't sound very good to me.
Ready to get back to work, but it's you know. But I'm healthy.
I tried to find you on Instagram, and I couldn't.
I'm not. Are you on Instagram? I'm not on Instagram. I'm not good with the social media.
Why?
I'm not very good at it. I tried Twitter for a month and it stressed me out too much. It's very stressful.
What's the stress about?
Because you have to, you know, thinking about what to post and everything. It's very, I don't know. I think other people are much, but I'm sure you're very good at it. I know people who are very good at it. It's just not my talent. I'm better off just making movies.
And that's what you do the best. How do your days go? Because you're such an active person.
Just trying to use the extra time right now to be doing prep, pre-prep. You know, we were going to be shooting a movie this summer, so that's been pushed. But now I have some extra time to, you know, work on storyboards and work on the script and things like that. So I'm able to fill the time.
You're not cleaning, you're not cooking, you're not buying.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, no, yeah. We're cleaning and dishes and laundry and all that stuff, and we got a, you know, 5-month-old baby, so that takes a lot of time too. So
there's I had no idea.
Oh yeah.
Congratulations.
Oh, thank you.
Is it a he or a she?
It's a he. He's a handful. He's very cute, but
next
that takes a lot of time off my plate too.
That's gonna be your next drummer.
Yes, exactly. I know. I'm getting him versed in music.
What kind of music does the baby listen to?
Oh, well, I made a playlist. You know, I'm trying to give him a little bit of everything. So there's, you know, one playlist is just all classical music, so he can get sort of steeped in European classical music. And then, but then I have a, you know, a jazz playlist and then, you know, more just kind of pop, sort of pop music playlist. So trying to give him a little bit of everything, but not just like children's music, you know. It's very important.
Yes.
Music and movies.
These two.
Those are the two most important things, obviously.
Damien Chazelle is probably the one director that comes to mind when you have Hollywood. Major Hollywood with lots of European sensibility.
Oh, cool. I like that.
Watching this series brings to mind a lot of, for me, Hungarian independent movies. So where does this come from? If I were Damien Chazelle today and I was 35, I would definitely go, Brad Pitt, Emma Stone, right after Ryan Gosling and Emma Stone.
Mm-hmm. I guess I've always been torn a little bit between the two because, you know, I live in Hollywood, as you say. I grew up wanting to be a part of Hollywood and loving big Hollywood movies. But I also equally loved European cinema and especially for my family, you know, they would try to, you know, I remember my mom or my dad when I was a kid showing me French New Wave movies or things like that to just try to, certainly a lot of French films. It was also a way for me to be learning French as I was a kid. And then we went to live in Paris for a bit. And when I was in Paris, that's when I really fell in love with the idea of, you know, just sort of going to see old movies in movie theaters. And you know, because it's such a great city for going to the movies. So I'd have my little copy of Periscope and I'd go on the subway and So that, and that would be a mix of movies. It'd be, you know, Hollywood movies, but also just a lot of things I would never be able to see back home in New Jersey. And then finally, the final component I'd say is documentary, which I really kind of got introduced to as a student. That's when I was in college, I started making documentaries, and that's where I really fell in love with things like old cinema verite and some of the, you know, some of the movies that inspired the French New Wave, like the movies of Jean Rouch or sort of, you know, 16 millimeter black and white films like that really inspired me. So I'd say those are three things: documentary, European cinema, and old Hollywood cinema, that I think I've always been a little bit, you know, ping-ponging between, but trying to combine a little bit.
But you are just equally fascinated by Hollywood.
Yes, yeah, for sure.
Now you're going to return to Hollywood with Babylon. I know it's under wraps, but you...
Well, you know, we were going to be shooting this summer, so we'll see when we can start shooting. It's something I've kind of been researching and trying to write for a while, and finally was able to get it down on paper a few years ago. And it's set in the 20s going into the 30s in Hollywood. It's sort of an ensemble piece, so following a few different characters in Hollywood of that time, during that transition from the 20s into the 30s. For me, it's just the sort of a story about how modern Hollywood came to be, I think, the birth of modern Hollywood, and how this old idea of Hollywood got replaced by something altogether different, which is sort of what we live with now.
Is it going to be a love story between Brad Pitt and Emma Stone?
No, there's no, I'm sorry, there's no love story between them. There's love stories between other people and between them and other people. It's a little bit of it's like a mishmash. There's a little bit of everything in it.
Promise me you're going to invite me to the set.
Yes. Well, as soon as we, yeah, I promise.
I wish you the best, darling.
Thank you so much.
And big kiss to you, and big kiss to Olivia, and big kiss to the baby.
Thank you.
The coronavirus should get a plane ticket.
First, yeah, go.
In an Uber, get itself a first class ticket and get out of here.
I agree. We can all make that happen. Oh, the moon is a great place. Yeah. Yeah, no. I went there a few years ago. Perfect for coronavirus. All right. See you, Nico.
Következő adásunkban Marozsán Erikával New Yorkból, Dakota Johnsonnal, Chris Martin a Coldplay szóló énekesének házából Los Angelesből, a többi pedig legyen meglepetés. Addig is, Hello Hollywoodból, sziasztok! Hello Hollywood.